Hi, I'd like to give you an update on the campaign. Campaign's been going quite well. We're still in the process of selecting the delegates, and there's a lot of things in motion. There's a time some of the workers and supporters get a little bit frustrated, but I'll tell you what, we're on target for what we had planned to do, and there's still a lot of activity going on. The delegate selection goes on for a couple more months, but we also need to keep up with fundraising too. The first thing I want to do is to really thank so many of you who have done so much and have responded almost every request. And that humbles me, to tell you the truth. And it really encourages me, too, to know that so many people will support. We don't get money from Goldman Sachs and these other big companies and Wall Streets and the military industrial complex. And you all know how difficult it is to keep going back and getting the small donations. But we are still very, very active. The season seems to be winding down, obviously because the early start and the big days are over, but there's quite a few primaries yet to come. And there's a lot of battles going on. I really appreciate those who know the rules and will go out and fight for our rights, that this whole idea that they resent what we do because we want to follow the rule book. So I'm delighted when somebody will stand up and be as polite as possible, but don't get pushed around as far as I'm concerned. But we do need some financial help. It needs to continue. And you know, on March 23rd, we're gonna have another money bomb. And this is a pretty good checkpoint to find out how far and how fast and what we can do here in the next couple months. But we're continuing. There's a lot of optimism. Even though they would like to downplay what we do and say, well, he's out of the race and all this, believe me, that isn't what they believe. They are very much aware of what we're doing and how much we can play a role, because our numbers have swelled tremendously, and they know there's a significant numbers. They're not only thinking about this Republican primary, but they're thinking the significance not only in the general election, but also for the future of this country. So once again, I want to thank you for all your support, and if all possible, please respond on March 23rd during the money bomb. Thank you.
If there is one thing that has distinguished the United States of America from the rest of the world, it is our unwavering belief in freedom. And if there is one thing that protects and upholds that freedom, it is the Constitution of the United States.
We came here looking for a subject that we had an arrest warrant for. Obviously, we didn't find it.
The Patriot Act
permits federal agents to write their own search warrants.
Roving wiretaps without having to identify the person.
Many Americans are being monitored.
The FBI monitoring young children.
Authorizes surveillance by suspicion, monitoring citizens not linked to any terrorist groups.
I don't think the Patriot Act would have been passed if it would have been called Repeal the Fourth Amendment Act.
Fourth Amendment, gone.
Do you want to have the government have the ability to send you to Guantanamo Bay?
The National Defense Authorization Act
gives the military the power to indefinitely detain American citizens
without trial,
suspected, not convicted.
When they say, I want my lawyer, you tell them, shut up.
Officially declares the United States a battleground.
It designates the world as the battlefield, including the homeland.
Sixth Amendment. Gone.
There is absolutely never a reason to give up 1 ounce of freedom for the sake of security. It won't work.
I, Barack Hussein Obama, will, to the best of my ability, preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution of the United States. So help me God.
My administration will not authorize the indefinite military detention. President Obama, on New Year's Eve, signed the National Defense Authorization Act.
No more national security letters to spy on citizens who are not suspected of a crime.
President Obama signed into law a 4-year extension of the Patriot Act.
Drones that Congress you love so much just passed a bill, which the president is expected to sign into law. Drone aircraft for use in American airspace by the year 2015. The agency officials say 30,000 of them by 2020.
They can be used for surveillance to establish daily routine.
From the moment that you walk out of your home in the morning until you return at night, your every movement will be tracked by this unseen eye in the sky.
Governor Romney, as president, would you have signed the National Defense Act?
Yes, I would have, and I do believe that it's appropriate. I think you want to use every tool that you can possibly use. The Patriot Act has clearly been a key part of that. All of us will be in danger for the rest of our lives.
There is no such society that I'm aware of where we've had radical individualism and that it succeeds as a culture.
There is such a society. It's called the United States of America.
This idea that people should be left alone, be able to do whatever they want to do. Government should keep our taxes down and keep our regulation low, and that we shouldn't get involved in the bedroom. We shouldn't get involved in cultural issues. That is not how traditional conservatives view the world.
They want you to believe that patriotism means that you support everything the government wants. A true patriot defends liberty and the people.
Politicians are politicians, but Ron Paul is a human being, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah! He's one of us, not one of them.
And the people know that the system we have is not working. It's not working economically. It's not working monetarily. Our foreign policy is not working. And therefore, they're looking for answers. They will not welcome us with open arms. But there is a vacuum out there. And the vacuum is not in one political party. It is pervasive. It's throughout the country. It is throughout the political system. Ideas spread. They can't stop them. An idea whose time has come cannot be stopped by any army or any government.
People are beginning to realize that the problem is too much government. We need more personal liberty.
Freedom is not something strange, and neither is it ancient. It's recent. Tyranny is ancient.
Don't give yourselves to these unnatural men. Soldiers, don't fight for slavery. Fight for liberty.
Forward! March!
Forward!